Hi everyone! Would you like to make mockups of your Redbubble products to promote sales and new designs? Redbubble offers some mockups as you upload a new design, but you might want to include multiple designs in one mockup to showcase a new sticker collection, or to have room to add a sales promo code as text, or just to not use the same promotional images that everyone else uses. Here's how to use the available templates on Photoshop. Start by going to the Redbubble blog and to the Promote Your Artwork category, which will be linked below. All of their mockup templates are listed in this section. There's templates for greeting cards, wall art, t-shirts, stickers, mugs, duvet covers, tote bags and so on. To get the template, click onto the blog post, download the template and unzip the package folder. And now you can open the template in Photoshop. I'm using Photoshop CC 2020 to make the mockups. If you don't have Photoshop yet, you can start a free 7-day trial. You can find the link on the video or below. You can open the templates in GIMP 2, which is a free image editor, but they won't work the same way. I'll explain that more a bit later. So let's start with this duvet cover. Open the template in Photoshop. To add your art to the template, double-click the smart object. In this one, it says main design, replace with yours. And then go to File and Place Embedded. Choose your artwork and click Place. Drag the corner to resize the artwork and press Enter when you're done or click the check mark. If you're using an older version of Photoshop, you might need to press Shift while resizing to keep the proportions, but in this version it's the opposite, so if you hold Shift, the proportions are not kept the same. Then go back to the template. I'll just show you what these layers are. So besides the main design, there's the background, there's highlights and a design mask, and there could be other adjustments depending on the template. Now, if you'd like to use GIMP for making the mockups, you can open these templates in GIMP and the background and adjustment layers will show up, but the smart objects won't work, so you can't add your artwork inside the main design layer like you can in Photoshop. Now, there's also room to add text, so click on the T for the text tool and you can change the alignment, color, font size and font type. Finally, save the image as PNG or a JPEG. And also save it as a PSD Photoshop file, so you can just quickly change the text and so on, without starting the whole thing from the beginning again. I'll show you a couple more different templates. Let's see these stickers on a guitar template. So for this one, you can add multiple designs into one mockup. So it could be an art series or just designs related to a certain theme or style. Just double-click the smart object again, and then you can add three sticker designs. And you can click the red box to make the bottom layer visible. That way you can see the exact areas to place the stickers in. So anything that's outside those white areas will not show up. Use File, Place Embedded to add the sticker designs. And you can again drag the corners to resize them, and you can also tilt the image when you have the cursor near the corner of the image and it turns into this curved two-way arrow, and then you can drag the image again to rotate it. Click Enter when you're done. Or you can also tilt the image by going to Edit, Transform, Rotate. Make sure to hide the Delete Me layer with the placeholder texts by clicking the eye icon next to it. And hide the red layer too. Press Ctrl S to save and go back to the template to see your artwork on it. Let's see what the design adjustments are for this template. Curves, exposure, blur, and the white border of the stickers. Next, let's look at one where the template has some alternative styles or colors. This is one of the t-shirt mockup templates. As usual, add your art to the smart object. And hide the placeholder text. The interesting part is the blue layer or the blue folder of layers that says shirt colors, only enable one layer. If you have all layers invisible, the shirt color is white, but the other options are coal, black and heather gray. The problem I have with these Redbubble templates is that they're kind of small. Mostly 1200 by 800 pixels, and most of them are landscape mode. They're big enough for some social media, but for Instagram you'd want at least a square of 1000 by 1000 pixels, and for Pinterest a vertical image would be better. For YouTube you'd need at least 1920 by 1080 pixels. If you'd like to see more image editing and print-on-demand tips, click on the videos on the screen. Thanks for watching! Bye!